Hello everybody, I am Quan from Vietnam. So today I come here to talk about our project. How we use the free and open source software and how we make it suitable with our condition. Some challenge, some issue that we met and how we overcome it. To introduce about myself, I am a free and open source software enthusiast. And before I joined the OpenSC project, we make a software for using smart card on PC. I also developed some software for OpenWRT. It's an operating system for Wi-Fi router, and I also developed software for my mobile phone. It's discontinued already. I also work as a mentor for Google Summer of Code. So now I and my friend start and stuff about agriculture. So what's the objective of our automatic system? We want a system to monitor the environment condition like temperature, humidity, dryness, and carbon dioxide, because we use this one to grow mushroom, and mushroom is not a tree, so it produces carbon dioxide. And it's getting in the oxygen. This system also has to allow remotely turn off the equipment like humidifier, light, aircon, and fan to adjust the environment condition. And we also want it to be automatically do that without human intervention. To explain about our software, we need to have an overview about our hardware, because our software need to work in specific hardware. Our hardware system include and gateway board. We use the Bivol board. It's an embedded computer similar to Raspberry Pi. From the gateway, we connect it with the sensor node. Each node will combine about 3 or 4 sensors to measure the humidity, the temperature. We also connect the gateway with the IP camera. And we connect it with the activator like the humidifier, the pump, the valve. And to access the system, we use the LAN network or internet, and we can see how system works from the laptop or smartphone. So our system can be called IoT, but it's different from other IoT system because it doesn't have a server, the cloud server. The reason is because we are lack of resources. We don't have enough money to buy server, to hire server. And also, the network infrastructure at my farm is quite poor. It doesn't have a stable internet connection. So we cannot rely on the internet, so no need to have a cloud server. Instead, this one will take the role of server itself. It's a mini computer, but we make it strong enough to do the job of server. So this is an overview of our hardware system. the ball, the bigger ball before is here. This is just small like that. This is the sensor node. So this is the ball of the node and the sensor here and here. This is a mushroom. This is mushroom is not sprout yet, but later on I will show the picture of mushroom. This is the humidifier. So it look not professional because we don't have money to buy professional device. So when we turn on, it will make some vapor, some water pouring down. And this is the light. We have the IP camera here. And so you start to see the mushroom flower in the environment. Now about the software. The main software is run in the gateway board. And we build it with Python and Django. And this application is also a web app because it has many modules. I will talk about the module later. So the stack here is like the usual Python web app. It has the Postgres, SQL database, the Redis, the Nginx web server. And in version 2 of the software, we add the InstructDB for time series database. This time series database is the data of the sensor. And we also have to make some script, some configuration to integrate well to the operating system, which run on the gateway board. It's the ARM Linux. So here is about how we access via internet. I forget this one. Sorry. So this is the three components of the software stack. The first one is control view. It provides a web interface for us to see the sensor value, and also it provides interface for the farmer to set the value they want for the temperature, the humidity. The second module is collector. This one is to talk with the sensor node to collect data. The third one is control center. This module will control the equipment in automatic mode or also program mode. And this is some minor tool to do other things like database backup and review the Postgres index to make it run faster. So this is the interface of the software. Later on, if still have enough time, I will demo it by access to the device in Vietnam to show you how it works. This is the chart it makes. The control interface. So we schedule the temperature, the humidity we want. For example, tomorrow we want how hot it is, how cold it is, and next day, so on. And after we set it, the system will automatically control the device to maintain that. So I think how I just to remotely access via internet before we use the VPN. The reason is that we at that time the network infrastructure is not good, we don't have a wide connection to the main router, so we have to use the wireless connection. And also we cannot do port forwarding on the router because that router belongs to the university and we don't have permission to change it. we borrow a room in university to do this project. Don't have enough money to rent out. This is also the reason why we don't rely on internet, because of this. Yeah, in Vietnam, sometimes the internet go down. The shark. The shark it the submarine cable. Yeah. So this is the VPN solution that we use. This to use VPN solution, one thing we need is that the gateway board has to have the internet connection. And this is, even this is unstable, but this is necessary because this board doesn't have the timer. So every time we turn it off and we turn it again, the clock will run. So it needs the internet connection to synchronize the time. And this is the two VPN solution we use. First we use Hamachi, but then we found many problems with it, and then we change to VPN. This one is open source, developed by Japanese. Some challenge we face in our project. The hardware specific issue is because of the ball we use, the bigger ball. So this one, to make it connect to the device like humidifier, fan, and pump, we have to use this feature of hardware. A GPIO pin, PWM and SPI pin. I think anyone study electronic in this room? Anyone? Oh, so I think you know about this. And one problem is that from the Linux view, this box, it needs root permission. It needs root permission to access it, to apply it. And so, and it's also the file under this directory. Normally, other device like USB device is under that. So we can change the permission easily. But for this thing, it is not under that, so we need other way to change its permission for our software to run. And we use the systemd. Anyone here know about systemd? So it's the software to start on other software in Linux computer. Another thing is about the pin of the hardware. This one. This is the one of the features that only happen on Linux for ARM. For the Linux for laptop, we don't have this problem because of the main board of the laptop. It has the BIOS. It said UEFI, but the big bond board doesn't have that, so it brings another issue. It's related to device overlay. So, one of the issues we find is that it doesn't work under Debian 7. It works under Debian 7, but doesn't work on Debian stage. So when we upload some software, sometimes it doesn't working. This one I already said before. So one thing is the software stack of the operating system. So because this board have a graphic user interface, but we remove it to have more RAM and CPU for our software. So to control network, we have to use this software from Intel to manage the network. But it's not too stable, and sometimes it breaks the time, internet time feature. And how we solve it, we disable the feature of software. This link is linked to a tutorial in Ask Leaders Wiki. Now we have a database issue. This one, this issue is when our software is in version 1. Some years ago. Now we already changed to version 2, but it is still new, so we haven't tested fully yet. So the problem is that our data is very heavy, so we record more than 80,000 records every day. So huge load for the database. And we found that our database sometimes slow down the system with 100% CPU. And how we solve it?
Why do you need to collect data every 10 seconds? I can't understand. I'm not a farm leader. Because the differential is minimum, I imagine. Maybe I'm totally wrong.
Yeah.
So you, it causes, you know, other problem which is more important to you. So if you collect data at a better interval, and then it's more measurable.
Yeah, for about how long, how often we should collect, we didn't have an exact criteria yet. So now we just test. We test with this time and that time and other number, and we will regularly find out which is the best number. Yeah. So we test with 10 seconds, and recently we test with 30 seconds. Yeah, but haven't found out which one is better yet. Yeah. So how we solve the issue with the database? We use this feature, this software of FOSSASIA to find out which query is the slowest. And then we use explain analyze of FOSSASIA to find out which operation is done and how long does it take. So we found which is the main bottleneck in the database operation. And we found some pieces like that. We found that FOSSASIA often has to scan all rows for some query. So to solve it, we build the index. But the index, the problem is that we have many rows of database, so we cannot build index for all the rows. It will be a huge waste of memory. So we just build index for the latest record. And after a while, we remove that index and rebuild the new index. And but it's shown most of the issue with high CPU usage, but sometimes that issue still happen when we exporting data, because our software have the feature to let billboard export the old data from 1 month ago, from 3 months ago. Now with version 2, we use the InfluxDB to store those data, but we have no result to compare it to PostgreSQL yet. And also this database is very new, so we still lack many tools and library. Okay, so now my talk is already finished. You have any question?
So the database you are talking about, it sits on the BeagleBone?
Yes, we run the database server on the BeagleBone also.
And what memory it's using? What memory it's using? SD card, NAND?
I only know it's a flash. I'm not sure if it's NAND or not.
Okay, yeah, flash. But with flash, we'll definitely have this database issues. And if database keeps writing to flash again and again, and one day the flash stops working.
Yeah. I also think about other solution that we. Use a microcomputer, it's called mini box, small computer like this. This one will run normal CPU and we can use it for database. But now because our need is not too much, we haven't seen any problem with the BeagleBone yet. So we haven't moved out to the normal PC. And even in the case we move to the normal PC, we still need this BeagleBone because of the feature to connect to other hardware, to other device.
How much is the cost?
The cost of which?
The BeagleBone
has to have power on the hardware. Oh, and also the room? The room will be... I know the price in Vietnamese money, but Singapore, I have no idea. Okay, I think around to 140 million dollars. Yeah.
This is the room only or everything?
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah, also to build the room, also to buy the buy for the equipment. Yeah.
Around 9,000.
I want you. What is your question?
The question is about the sensor and the actuator.
Yeah.
So, how long do you think your sensor will last? Because the usage is very high.
Yes.
Because due to the way, you know, this thing has been sending out signal with this high frequency, and I believe this must be 24/7. So, and also the way your actuator, because I believe this is to help high growth in mushrooms. So, this replacement and scalability, you know, I'd like to hear a bit on that.
About how long the sensor can last, we have...
And also, have you considered things like using LDPT, you know, stuff, which may be able to do some work?
LDPT?
Yeah, low energy Bluetooth.
Low energy Bluetooth. Actually, about the sensor, we use the RF radio frequency to transfer the data. So this one is cheaper than the Bluetooth.
Yeah.
A beacon is really cheap.
Which one is cheap?
Like beacon, if you buy by bulk.
Beacon.
Yeah.
in Vietnam, I think not easy to find that. Yeah.
So the sensors like cost with sensors are basically they can directly connect to the bigger core data. They don't need a beacon at all.
Because depends on.
It's a different scale.
The bigger you can find much better. Where you are.
I mean, but in this case they don't need wireless connection at all.
Oh yeah. Because of sharp, so I was thinking. I'm sorry.
Okay. So.
How many times and how much
value
are you made the mushrooms?
This month we start the second crop of mushroom. Yeah.
And one crop, how much the main mushroom?
The room is 10 square meter. Yeah. It's just for experiment. So. In this time, we are just experimenting to improve our system and also to find out the cultivation process. Because one problem about the agriculture in Vietnam is that they doesn't have any, they doesn't have the detail of cultivation process. It's like today, with how much mushroom, what is the temperature it needs, how is the humidity it needs, how is the brightness it needs, doesn't have a detailed number yet. So we have to experiment and find out ourselves. Yeah.
It's your own project or support from some university or agency?
Our startup is new and only have 4 people, and we haven't found the fund yet. We haven't had fund yet. Yeah,
startup.
Yeah,
startup.
Yeah.
Are you looking for crop modules?
Looking for?
Crop modules, because they do sell those now. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Crop module.
They can plug into your bigger board and they can keep time.
Oh, yes, your company's brand. You will sell your mushroom grow product or you sell the mushroom?
About a week we can sell. I think it's the business issue that we haven't have a clearly vision yet. Because sometimes we think that if we sell the system, the hardware and software, we can sell it in the short term, but in the long term when other competitors appear, we cannot earn money much with it. And we think that maybe we grow the mushroom ourselves and sell the mushroom. But then we come to meet some business expert. They advise us that direction is not safe because we sell the software, the hardware for this customer. And then after that, we sell the mushroom, we become the competitor of that customer. So the customer will not be just us, we will not buy the device from us. So it's the business issue that we haven't, we cannot show yet. Still think.
Okay, yeah. I understand. Thank you for answering.
Yeah, thank you. Do we still have time?
I have a question. Have you compared the effectiveness between using your system and without your system?
For other systems, I haven't found other system in Vietnam yet.
Yeah. It's when you use your system, so how much you can earn from the mushroom, and without your system?
About that, we cannot give the correct answer because our system still not complete.
Sorry, we are running out of time. If you have more questions, you can ask him.